Ajna Wellbeing. Welcome to day 7 of your 7-day yoga course. And well done for making it this far. And thank you for joining me on the journey. So today, day 7, we get to do some lovely restorative yin style yoga. It's mostly been more of a yang style up until now. So we're going to use a bolster for today. If you don't have a bolster, you can use blocks, you can use pillows, maybe some cushions or like rolled up towels. Just be creative and find what works for you. So this is my Ajna Wellbeing one. It's really beautiful and soft, the Eco Suede. I've also got my meditation cushion here in the organic cotton, and I'm going to sit on this to start with as we do a little bit of meditation. And we're just going to do a listening meditation to begin with. So let's take a few breaths to start with, together. Let the eyelids shut down, bring your palms face down. Elevate the spine and just tuck the chin slightly so it's in alignment. And let the belly be really soft and take a deep breath into the belly. You can take one hand there if you want, or two hands, and feel it expand as you breathe into it. Inhale. And then exhale, pour it out. And again, inhale. And exhale. Just follow the breath with your mind's eye. And again, inhale. And exhale. Bring your hands back to your knees, palms face down. So I want you to use your sense of hearing and see how far away from you you can listen. So wherever you are, can you hear outside of the room what's happening? Can you hear cars or people? What about even further than that? Can you hear down the road? One bolster is enough. This is is a similar to a lizard pose as you would do in yoga. So I'm going to step my right foot forwards and I'm going to lower my back knee down onto the bolster. Now you might need two bolsters, you might need three bolsters, that's okay. You could even add a cushion and a bolster, and that might be a good spot for you. In fact, I might do that as well. So this is a slightly more yang yin pose, if that makes sense. It's a bit more energetic one, so we're not completely relaxed, but we're still using the line on our bolsters here to prop us up so we can find that relaxation. And that's it there. So you're just going to settle down. Now you can come down if you want onto your forearm, onto your forearms. You can let your head relax as well. We want to feel this into the front of the hip, down here. If you feel it there, even slightly, it's working for you. It doesn't need to be a huge stretch. And with all these poses, we want to stay here and find some stillness. It's really tempting a lot of the time to fidget around and get comfortable. See if you can find stillness and then breathe and let go as much as possible. And that's how you access the fascia. So the fascia is this sort of connective tissue, goes around the muscles, and it goes all the way from our head, top of our head, all the way through our body, down to our feet. It's one of the only tissues, I think, that does that in the body, goes through the whole body. And the way that we access it is holding these stretches for a long time. You won't do it by just doing a short stretch and going back. So finding stillness, using the breath. I think that's already been about a minute, so I'm going to just gently come out of it. You want to move very slowly out of these positions. And let's just come back. I'm going to move this over slightly. I'm going to step my left foot forward this time, sit up for this pose on the other side, so propping myself up there. It's actually really nice having that extra elevation. Just allows me to sink a little bit deeper and not have to hold on so much. So you don't want to be holding on, you want to be relaxing into it. I'm going to come down onto my forearms because that feels good to me, but you don't have to. Finding stillness. Finding the stretch in the target area, which is our hip, and then breathing. That's all we have to do. And it's also helpful, I find it helpful to take a little mental scan from the top to the bottom, as if you're scanning a barcode, finding any points of tightness or tension, and then seeing if you can release them. Sometimes you don't even realise how much you're holding on. Like a lot of time, we have tension in our jaw, our face, our stomach, our hips. And it's not until you actively or try to release them that it lets go. So we'll take a few more breaths here in this position. Or in the body along the meridian lines that we're working into. Any sensations at all, it's your opportunity to just meditate on that. Good, from there, let's come up to sit. And we're going to take a nice forward fold. So again, I think I'm going to use both of these. You could use two bolsters. You could use a bolster and a block. We're sitting up tall. And then all you're doing is relaxing forward or over. So now, this one, our target area is down the back of the leg, even a little bit into this spine, so that whole posterior chain. If you feel it anywhere in that posterior chain, then you are doing it correctly, okay? So just, you can turn your head to one side. That might be a nice option for you. Or straight ahead. It's completely up to you. Let the arms be heavy. It's not so much about the shape as making sure that you're feeling it into the right spot. And again, find stillness. Taking that mental scan. Where can you do less? Where can you let go a little bit more? What is it that you're resisting? Responsible for rest and digest. Our sympathetic is the one that we don't want to be in too much of the time. It's our fight, flight response. We want to get into this parasympathetic nervous system stimulation, and that's how we do it with these really long holds and deep breathing. So the next one that we're going to do is simply a child's pose. I'm just going to use my bolster for this one, but again, you take as many drops as you need. You'll feel this again a little bit into the bath. This one is a more yin pose. It's a really soft pose, and nice, and you're going inwards. Feels quite safe and lovely. So from here, you can simply take the legs either side of your bolster, come forwards. You can hug your bolster this way. If you want to turn your head, I suggest turning it halfway through to the other side, just so that you're even, or you can take it forward. And melting your hips down. No tension. Let your belly hang nicely between your legs there. Really soften the belly. Really soften the face. Soften the fingertips. Soften everything. Soften the skin. If you have your head turned, you can turn it to the other side now. Sometimes it feels like you're not doing anything until you come out of it and you realize, oh yeah, actually that did do something. And that is actually the key to it. It nearly has to feel like it's not doing much at all. Then you come out of it and you feel the restorative benefits of it. I'm going to take four more breaths here. Just preparing mentally that we are going to start to move again. And from there, making your way out of the pose. We're going to take our bolster horizontal now. We've got two more poses. Let's bring our feet over. Come all the way onto your back. Press your feet into the ground. Just slide your bolster up that way. So this is actually our pose. It's just a supported bridge pose. The bolster is under your pelvis. And then you have the option, if you are, depending if you have a bad back, you may not want to do this, to extend the legs out long. So opening gently through the front of the body. You can also play around with taking the legs wider, closer. It is a gentle back bend, so you may feel it into the back. And that's why I suggest if you have lower back problems, maybe this one's not for you, or maybe you keep the feet on the ground. Again, find your stillness, your physical and mental stillness. Let everything go. Anything that's happened in your week or your day, just let it go for now. Allow yourself this moment to just be fully present. Your heart meridian, you can cactus your arms. Or another nice option is to take one to your belly, one to your heart. And just feel yourself breathe. the other leg up as well. So just legs up, this is the pose. You can do this up against the wall, which will be a little bit more relaxation because you won't have to hold your legs at all. But just let the legs be soft. You don't need to stretch them. Just let them sort of dangle there. And this is a gentle inversion. So inversions, anything where your feet are higher than your heart. Really good for anxiety and stress. And again, accessing that parasympathetic nervous system. So this is a really nice way to finish. And to finish your day, if you've had a stressful day. Put your legs at the wall for a minute before you go to bed. We've got four more breaths here in our final pose for this sequence. And again, just remember that you can spend up to close to 5 minutes in if you want in these poses. I'd suggest maybe three, but minimum 1 minute. So if you do want to stop and pause the video and spend a bit longer, then you can do that, of course. Okay, we're going to come out of this pose. So bring your soles of your feet down to the mat. So lift your hips up, slide your bolster away. We're done with that. Give your knees a squeeze in, gentle sway side to side. And then just bring the soles of the feet back down and give your knees a windscreen wiper side to side. It's nice because that was a gentle back bend. This just releases any tension in this lower spine. And from here, we're just going to come into our shavasana. Take an extra long shavasana today, you've earned it. And another nice thing with the bolster is to place it underneath your knees. Again, it's totally up to you. But give it a try, see how you feel. See if that feels better or different to you. And from there, just take a deep inhale, exhale. Find that gorgeous stillness. A few quiet moments before you go back to whatever you have on in